a beautiful, beautiful tarpon. Gorgeous, gorgeous fish. Just look at that. Beautiful purples and greens in there. Oh, slipping back over. Hey guys, Captain Frazier here. Today we're here in Everglades National Park, and this is a follow-up video to one previously I did making this flyman guide fly kit. And wow, this tarpon rolling all around me here. And this flyman guide fly kit minnow, it's a skull minnow, and I have a previous video that we tied this up in. And I'm trying it out here today in the Everglades in the backcountry on my Ginu for snook and tarpon, mostly juvenile, but hopefully we'll get into some bigger fish as well, including the snook. So we'll see how that goes. All right. This is a snook. Got close to the bushes and the snook was up in there. Competed with it with some tarpon. I don't know, the hook might be, I don't know, we'll see. The hook might be a tad big, I don't know. I think it's a 2, it's a little bigger than what I would use for baby tarpon. I think I would probably use a slightly smaller hook. Snook probably alright. A little small snook. Not bad. Fish are feeding in here pretty hard. I don't think they're pretty much hitting anything that's moving right now. Let's see if we can get this guy in here. Not a bad snook. Certainly not a PB, but we'll take it. Good fun. On the 6-weight. Man, he gave him a chance to inhale that. Let go of my thumb. Alright, little buddy. Alright. Alright. I think what I'm gonna do. I think what I'm gonna do is definitely shorten this leader a little bit. Might be a tad bit long. Oh, he destroyed this fly. Oh, he sucked that thing right down. Alright, so this was, I was fishing with almost a 12 foot leader, really, which I think is probably way too much. I had it left over from bone fishing. So that's 6. I think I'm going to cut it down to about 7 or 8. Alright, just using a loop knot here, Rapala knot, loop knot, perfection loop, some people call it. About as long as I make it there. Fly's getting a little tore up now, had lots of hits, the eyes are gone. Skull's still holding tight, so is the super glue, so looks like one of these minnows, fleeing minnows. Trick to this one is quick and slow. That's darting minnow, how they move. Quick and slow. It's fleeing minnow. Alright, let's go. Alright, we'll do this on the back cast. Right in there. Little tailing loop underneath. There he is. Should be a little juvenile tarpon. There he goes. Solid little eat. Not that this fish deserves the fly line, but I'm gonna clear it anyway. I'm in such a small boat. Try and keep that tension consistent. Oh, so to speak, as I just let some slack in the line. Finish getting this guy on here. Nice little tarpon. Oh, sweet. That guy fly certainly works. Man, I think we'll just maybe grab the net. I always like to net them, but certainly by myself, might do less tiring on the fish. To get him back into the boat, since it is just me. I don't want to tire the fish out more than I need to, so we'll get him in here. See if we can get a couple others. Nice tarpon and snook. Yeah. And this is what to expect. You know, I got my Ginu in the backcountry here in the Everglades. Certainly good fun. There's bigger fish here. I've hooked up to 40, 50 pounds in these back lakes. Snook over slot, of course, seen larger. Certainly this winter, as the fishing gets better, as these fish seek out stable, darker, warmer water, as the cold fronts push through November, December, January, February, they'll winter back here. And certainly want to see if I can get a PB snook, which would, for me, would be over slot on fly. Certainly I've caught 45 inch snook on live bait, which was pretty good. Oh, there you go. But one on fly, definitely one that's, you know, that I'd like. Certainly fished in Jupiter a couple times over the summer, trying to get one off the beach. Had a couple close calls, but just didn't have enough time, really. It's an hour and 45 minutes from my house, so it's a little trek. Almost 2 hours up there. Alright, see if we can finish this guy off here. I think he sees the net, he don't like it. We are pre-front conditions right now. Pre-front conditions with the cold front coming through. The first one really of the season here. We're in October. And so pre-front, the rain will start for the next 3 days. Temperature will drop. Wind's going to pick up to 20. So this was really my last window of opportunity to get in here. we'll be sail fishing on kite and doing some trawling here. There he is. Come on, buddy. On the big boat, on the 68 Viking. I have a 22 Pathfinder that I fish, but I fish inshore with that. All right, there he is. Beautiful. Beautiful, nice tarpon. All right. And there he is. Real nice. Perfect juvenile species of the tarpon. Go ahead and get this slack out here. There he goes. Sweet, let's see if we can get another one. Awesome fish. Oh, there he goes. Let's see if we can see if we get another one. Oh God. That was hard. Ooh, another tarpon here. Just let that twitch pause on that fly, and it just sort of drizzled around and sunk a little bit, and man, that thing really did work. I mean, I'm getting plenty of bites. Definitely a good one here. And certainly I had my share of bites to the actual fish coming off. Fly's working for sure. Bite him right off the rod tip here. I'm gonna go for the net. And we'll get this over with pretty quick, I think. Hopefully before he can see that net. Well, he saw it. And they jump, you know, just kind of go with them. No, not slack, but not totally limp on them. You know, bowing to the king, but not introducing slack, but just a light tension, a loosening of the wrist, so to speak. All right, let's see if we can just slide it right underneath him here. Ooh, hard to do by myself. 9-foot rod. Probably a 7-foot net. Oh. All right, I'm gonna hand line this guy. There he goes. Ooh, still green. A good thing. Beautiful, beautiful tarpon. Certainly that fly is working, using the net, and don't want to tire these fish out too much. All right, and there he is. A beautiful, beautiful tarpon. Gorgeous, gorgeous fish. Just look at that. Beautiful purples and greens in there. Oh, slipping back over the side. There it is. The TFO Mangrove Coast. TFO Power. Beautiful. All right. Well, I think I might be done. A couple tarpon, plenty of jumps, snook. Fly definitely works. Getting better as it gets beat on a little bit.